Like most floor plans, the living room truly is the introduction to the rest of the house. This homeowner has a simple request, how to finish. And they've made some beautiful decisions. Notice how edited all the backgrounds are. They have some nice neutral upholstery, ready to layer on and give personality to, and they've got some wonderful spaces. We're going to be focusing on three ideas. One is how to take this wall and really anchor it and truly create that one visual snapshot that allows the rest of the room to play off of. Two, we're going to talk about this wonderful anteroom and how to add depth and layer in some personality. And three, this quirky fireplace. We're going to see what we can do to really give it a finished feeling. Now's the time that I get to surround myself with beautiful things and see what starts to come together. I'd like to place the sofa on the main wall by pulling her two club chairs here close by, arranging those lovely two vintage chairs here by the fireplace, and anchoring them all with her family rug, we really do begin to have a nice cross-conversation area. I remember she had a great mood shot of some box shelves, kind of painted, a little bit of a lacquered finish on the back that would be wonderful in a vertical statement here down the right side. In the anteroom adjoining the living room, we were going to consider a great texture to feature that lacquered chest she had here. Now when you get down to it, there's probably a little bit of an additional requirement of a furniture piece here will then kind of play in contrast to the radius on the fireplace. After you've got your furniture all in the right place, really the next thing to talk about is mood. And there is so much freedom when it comes to mood. The photos that this couple sent are all over the place, which is a good thing. There's lots of color, lots of mix and match of different styles, very somewhat European eclectic. Really gives you a lot to bite into and makes it a lot of fun. The element that has to be considered sooner than later is the rug, because it really does send us in a color direction. She picked a wonderful neutral for the wall, and all her large upholstery is in a nice texture. Again, very neutral. This sets me up to begin playing with color. Her vintage chairs are very stylized and somewhat salon in feeling, lots of movement in line. So I think it would be fun to make them a little crazy. There's an opportunity in the arm of that chair to pull in a nice nail head trim and somewhat follow the outline of the chair and maybe play with two different fabric selections. Now that we've got what's going on the chairs, I want to make sure we repeat that depth of color in some pillows and some throws. So I've pulled a couple wonderful reds that play with the rug and that will be used as pillows. I don't really care what the selection is in this moment because I want to do some shopping. I want to be open to what I might be able to find out there in the stores. For the vestibule off the back of the living room, I really want to maximize the opportunity to create depth. This paper has a wonderful texture to it and a little bit of a metallic slub. And I'm even inspired, instead of use it by the roll, to cut it up into squares and install it kind of like a checkerboard to create that extra interest. The radius of the fireplace creates an interesting challenge. You really can't hang art on it, and I really enjoy the texture. So I'm wondering what to do. I found this shot, which kind of streamlines a little bit of a collection mounted on little brackets. And I'm thinking that that might be a great way to go as far as buying some vessels or some sort of antiquity or some sort of collection and just hanging them somewhat randomly on the face of the radius. I think that'll be fun. Plus, if I get to use the lucite for the bracket, it adds a little bit of that glisten that I'm always looking for. I think we've got our plan, we've got our mood, we've got our main elements, and we have a nice mix. Might need to do a little bit of shopping, but I'm really looking forward to the install. So check it out, we've got a finished space on our hands. The candles are burning, the artwork is hung, the pillows are placed. It has a nice, finished, welcoming feel. Remember, we started with nice neutral backdrops with great neutral furnishings, but typical, a homeowner didn't know where to go next. They own this great rug that had been in the family, but it really wasn't their current aesthetic as far as things being clean and easy. So we combined them, and my team worked hard. They found all these great, affordable faux furs and fun pillows and just little touches that added that glamour combined with a little bit of exotic. If you recall, the furniture placement changed. The main sofa was here, but by pushing it back here against this wall, even though it's a little more typical, we were really able to anchor that visual snapshot. Remember, something we always strive for is to create that one sight line and finish it top to bottom, even if you're leaving other areas in the room unfinished. Always drive that one sight line home. I love the mood shot of the boxes hanging on the wall. And to give them a little bit more scale, we went ahead and painted a great paint color behind them, kind of unifying them and grounding them, giving them a little bit of extra depth. I love the way that the mirrored table kind of makes everything reflective, and the cut votives and the burning candles just gives everything a little bit of that glamorous quality. Because again, remember, we were kind of wanting to mix glamour with super comfort. The way my team did the wall on the fireplace and like combined, I want to say we talked about Lucite cubes with some sort of collection. Simple lacquered cubes with fan coral, very affordable, kind of adds a little bit of that natural organic feel, perfect for a sleek and comfortable room. I love the fun mix of the vinyl and that smoky velvet on the vintage chairs. Not exactly what we talked about, but it truly followed the plan. We have this great space off the living room, kind of this anteroom, and we remember we wanted to add that subtle little detail, just a simple wall covering cut into squares that would add a very subtle, barely there, something you might notice later, a little element that just makes that space kind of special. And a nice collection of stone finials, which just can just kind of push to the side if she wants to use it as a server. The final touch is that little layer of personalization. Just sprinkling around and surrounding yourself with things that you love.